here we are at episode 4, in sheep's clothing. I assume that's gonna relate to, like, somebody having more to do with things than they appear kind of thing. Well, I have, you know, played this game. I have a really bad memory. Seriously, my Patronus would probably be a fucking goldfish in Harry Potter if, you know, that was legit.
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
So, I don't remember a lot of the smaller things in this game. I remember some of the bigger things, like Snow, you know, not really being dead when you find her, you know, her head without a body.
How could you do this to me?
But a lot of this stuff I really don't remember.
I finally see you for who you are! Tell me who did it! Just tell me who did it! I know you know!
I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women?
Oh man, the end of the last episode was so intense. I don't know how fucking Big B's gonna recover from that, like, and still do his job.
But, you know.
Just take him, okay? Take Crane.
Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen.
I wonder, when she says long live the queen, is she referring to herself? Who? What queen? Get a fucking couch, Bigby. That is his blood. Nice. No? No. Oh, it is his blood.
See you around.
Hollow point bullets are a nasty business. The silver slug deformed and shredded on impact.
He'll be okay, though.
Give him some painkillers, numb
him
up.
He'll be okay?
His internal organs are positively riddled. If I don't extract every single scrap of silver, he's liable to suffer some long-term toxicosis.
Shouldn't this be done in a sterile environment?
To move.
This doesn't look good. Oh my god, his arm!
Boy. I figured I'd be done before you were conscious.
Swinehart, how bad is it?
Well, not the worst I've seen, but damn near it. I must say, you're testing even my skills here.
Oh my god, stop showing his arm!
Doctor!
Look, I'm a bit engaged saving his life at the moment, but if the fractured extremity concerns him that much, he can set it himself.
Oh god, you're gonna make me do- Okay, before we do this, there's a new Fable entry. Oh god. Definitely on par here when with, you know, when Clem has to sew herself up. It's pretty bad. Okay. Doc, I'm trusting you to get everything out of there. Alright. Oh. Here we go. I'm not gonna have to press. Of course you're gonna make me literally do it. I don't wanna show it. Oh. At least the bone's back. No. No, he failed. Okay, let's do it again. Oh my god, Big B, you must have some, like, ridiculous pain tolerance. Like, simply ridiculous. Like, Bloody Mary would have a lot of fun, probably, with you.
Not bad. That'll do, I suppose. He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this. He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
I feel like he will listen now.
It's not like I asked for this shit to happen.
Yes, but it's not like you actively discouraged it either.
You weren't there, you don't know what happened. I should have killed Tweedle. I still regret it.
Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay, at least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands. And I need the space to work, so if you
I want her mind, to do her job, but...
Stick around, all right? I don't know if I trust this guy.
Oh, please, I could do this with my optic nerve severed. We'll be done in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
I just feel like the evening since we saw Auntie Greenleaf has gone badly with Snow.
Hey, Doc,
I want her to
longer?
Know I still
Colin,
I still like her.
It's finished when it's finished.
Because I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be?
Could you please not distract the doctor while he has my chest cut open?
Yes, that would be helpful. There. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to, having visits with me. And, well, this time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue. Miss White, he'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been an unusual couple of days.
Yeah.
But please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him. Please.
Let him do some paperwork.
He will. He'll need rest, I assume?
Sleep, mostly. Just keep watch, and make sure he doesn't get into further altercations.
I'll try.
Thanks, Mom and Dad.
Anyways, guard against, as they say. Miss White? Sheriff? Colin?
Swiney?
That's not a good idea,
so,
Bigby. Alcohol's
you,
a blood thinner.
Feel?
You're bleeding.
It's Bigby,
feel like
Snow.
Shit.
You'll be okay.
How do you think I feel? Like shit.
You should see how you look.
I'm sorry I was mean,
I'm
but...
I'm glad you're not dead.
Damn, he must feel like such shit.
You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess.
Don't touch his broken arm!
It kind of scared the hell out of me. I've never seen you like that.
I'm pretty hard to kill.
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong
Thanks
way.
Thanks for ruining our moment, Colin.
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there?
Mind your business, pig.
Do you guys have like a plan or something? And who should I be asking? Should I be worried about the crooked man taking
I don't know
over?
What to say, so I'm going to say nothing.
Or is Crane still the thing?
He doesn't need to know.
The crooked man came out of the shadows for a reason. For him to attack us so blatantly like that. He either feels invincible or desperate.
Well, if those are my two options, I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying, that's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house money.
So he called my bluff. It's not like I'm gonna let Bloody Mary just murder.
Yeah, thanks, Snow.
I mean, yeah.
All that back there.
We had to give up Crane, but...
No problem.
She did
thanks.
Save his life.
You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop? Or that the crooked man thinks he's got Snow under his thumb?
We're all mad about it, Colin.
What else could Snow do? If she didn't hand him over, my ass would be down the witching well. And Crane still would have been taken.
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
All I care about right now is... just what does the Crooked Man want out of this? I thought he was just a loan shark, but clearly he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with Faith and Lily?
You know, I couldn't really give a shit what they want out of this. They just made the wrong fucking enemy.
Take
Remember
it easy, though.
Swinehart said, okay?
Hey, a sleeper hit is much better. You know, they think they're safe, and then you attack.
Against us last night.
You know?
At least that's what I thought when it happened. But now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken. We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean, the right way?
What do you think I mean?
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way.
Look, I know things haven't gone great recently, but we're still doing our best.
That's not good enough.
It has to be. We're government workers.
So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
I disagree.
Pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of...
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters to fight monsters.
I'm sure from your vantage point, it's extraordinarily easy to judge me.
Bigby.
But you sit behind a desk all day. And only tonight did you see what it's like to be pushed into a corner all the time just for doing your job.
You think I don't know what it's like to have my life in danger? To not be pushed to do things?
Well, it's not for your job.
I know what it's like. And I know what it's like to lie to yourself. To justify what you've done. So don't talk to me like I'm other people. Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile and shave and take a shower now and then. Hell, I'm practically the president of the Bigby Don't Be Such a Dick Club. But this is the wrong fucking time to put shackles on him.
I kind of agree. I should have said thanks, Colin.
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay? It's just that now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect. And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the farm.
Oh, give me a fucking break. Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
That's not gonna happen.
Yes,
it will.
It's an impossible rule to enforce, Snow. You really expect to round up every talking cat and raven in town?
There's not that many stragglers left. Except the one or two you make excuses for.
You're gonna
for.
Send Toad and Toad Jr.? You're gonna send little TJ?
Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it? Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks.
I think Bigby should rest for 24 hours. At least.
Narissa.
Narissa?
That broad from the pudding and pie?
Yes. Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. And what do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised.
She knows something. She's helped me a little with the case. Maybe she has something else.
Maybe she does. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking calls. And I should probably change out of these clothes.
Yeah.
Consider the discussion tabled, but not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work. Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
I'm not, but if she does it...
She seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here.
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you. Don't worry about it.
Thanks, Bigby.
Something tells me that, Bigby's not gonna be the end-all word on that. And that Colin's gonna get sent back.
Thank you.
I feel like so Hi, much always happens, Sheriff. Like, before the song, the theme, or whatever. So. Like, this game is just packed full of stuff.
Have a seat.
Look at his little tiny office. He doesn't spend much time here, I guess, because this is really the first time we've been here in the game, I think.
Are you okay? You didn't look good last night. I wasn't sure you'd be...
I'm fine. Don't worry about me.
How did I know he was gonna cough and pick up a cigarette? Cause that'll help.
Huffin' Puffs. Not many people smoke those. Thanks.
So what is it you wanted to talk to me about? I know what you did for me, sending me to the open arms. And I think you want to help me again.
There's not a lot that I can talk about. You know that.
Can you write it down?
That spell Crane was trying to break. It's not just while you're at work, huh?
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the pudding and pie, I told you what I was looking for. You found a way to tell
me. I'm gonna have to figure out the right things to say to get her to talk.
Again?
You can try. I just...
Yeah, I know.
Go ahead.
You're here because the Crooked Man just sent Crane to the bottom of my list of worries. And you have something you want to say about that, right?
These lips are sealed.
You can't nod or shake your
if
head.
I could answer you just like that. I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
Sometimes, we have to find our way through life on our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark. I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now... They're gone. And I don't know what to do.
Are you saying you need a friend right now? You can trust me.
What I'm saying is friends matter. And I don't have any left. So I hope you're looking after yours. Are you? Look around you.
Who are you talking about? Are my friends in danger?
I'm sorry. I thought I could do this. I need you to know I want to help, but...
I understand.
But...
It's okay. Take your time.
I'm sorry if I'm wasting your time. I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons. Faith wore one too, huh?
Do you like it? Do you?
It's not how it looks that concerns me. It's what it does.
I feel like That's why you someone can't tell me mentions the ribbon, they have to ask if they like it. It's part of the spell.
Can't we just take the ribbon off?
No! These lips are sealed!
What?
You can't! Just stay back!
Okay. Okay, must
you
be part of the spell.
Do that!
Slow down. It's alright. I'm not gonna do anything.
Just asking.
Please, don't.
No, I won't. Don't worry.
Okay. I get it. So the ribbons, if you take them off...
Her friends are dead. She's sad and she's scared. She wants to help. So let's be nice.
If anyone finds out I came here...
That's probably Snow.
Listen, Sheriff. Can you keep this conversation between us?
Yes.
I could be in a lot of... trouble.
I won't tell anyone, don't worry.
Thank you.
Although Snow already knows you're here.
Sorry, I just need to talk to the sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
1 minute.
I might have a new lead for you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now. They said they wanted to talk to you about something. I wonder if they've heard about Crane.
Thank you for listening, Sheriff.
Probably not.
You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time.
Wait, you don't have to go.
Unless... Well, Beauty's involved with
that
the Crooked Man, so...
Abrupt?
That's one way to send a message.
What did she tell you? I didn't mean to rush her out.
She told me enough. I think she told both of us with the way she just left.
Okay then. Good work.
Why does she look upset?
So, about Beauty and Beast. Do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look?
Seeing as Nerissa was let go there, you won't be wasting your time. But, I won't rat Nerissa out if Beauty didn't... Not Beauty, Snow didn't catch it.
Take out a loan from the Crooked Man. Seems like a pretty bad deal.
I can only imagine what they're thinking now.
Did she press the button or the center?
We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what? I have other matters to attend to.
Bye. Alright, which apartment is theirs?
You didn't want to tell me what you were into either.
Good reason. Look what happened.
So that's back on me now. I thought we agreed that...
Oh. What do you want? Well? You're just going around knocking on doors?
You called, right? Or, was it Beauty?
Why would I call you?
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
You think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted to talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
That's nice.
So have you, Bigby.
Don't care.
Yet, with all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy.
You're not the bad guy, you're just in my way.
I had to hear about it all night long from her.
Who is it? Who's there?
Look, I'm coming in. So, let's not get into busting down doors today, all right?
It's your pal, Bigby.
Jealous
Hi,
much?
Baby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
Oh, really? You're gonna invite me in and then go finish your conversation? Whatever.
Yes, I really do have the smallest apartment in the Woodlands.
This is a nice apartment.
I can tell you're going to make a problem out of this.
What are you doing?
Rose.
You don't need to bring him into this.
Beast.
I just don't think we can trust him. Not after the way he went behind my back. And then you run and call him again?
Well, I trust him.
Of course you do. He was keeping secrets for you.
It was one little thing.
Talk about living in the past.
Yeah, they have that, like, right in their fucking living room. You know, if they had, like, any Mundy friends, they'd come over and be like, wow, you guys really dig your marriage, don't you?
That's why I called.
Must be something I'm supposed to be finding here.
But we need to talk to Bigby.
Fine. If you want to talk, we'll talk.
He can't go over by the fireplace.
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah,
You know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
Beast!
No, really, I want to know. What are you trying to say, huh?
I thought you were having money problems, but it doesn't look like you're suffering to me. Is this something about that loan you took out? From the crooked man?
I didn't know what else to do, so...
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate things.
I called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out.
I feel you, Bigby.
Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
Look, I'm not here to referee. You called me, okay? So cut the bullshit and quit wasting my time.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the Crooked Man?
Tell me.
What if we talk and you don't get him? And all this comes back on us? We'd be risking a lot.
Then don't say anything.
We've seen what happens when you cross the Crooked Man. And I don't know if it's worth it. If you can't give us certain assurance.
I can't tell you what he's gonna do.
If you have info on that crooked bastard, I need to hear it. Otherwise, I've got better things to do.
No, please don't.
Then tell me what the fuck is going on. You're in so much debt? Look around you. This isn't the way people short on cash live.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that up.
We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn, and we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just lived like...
Aren't you gonna answer that? Who's calling so late?
Hi there, you've reached Beauty.
And Beast.
And we're out doing something fabulous.
They're horrible.
Let me just,
A day at the beach?
Skiing the slopes?
And we can't come to the phone right now, so leave a message at the beep and we'll get back to you as soon as...
What the fuck was that?
Don't worry about it.
I should have stopped him.
Probably just a wrong number. Really?
Fine. I'm sure you can handle whatever this is on your own. I'll see you later.
Please, Bigby. Wait. We've been getting horrible phone calls. It's the Crooked Man's people. Trying to collect, and we aren't safe. Even in our own home.
We owe some money.
Finally. All I care about is, how can I find the Crooked Man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before. So, when I needed money... That's where I went.
Did you ever see the Crooked Man there? When you got your loan? Or just shopping?
No, never. But come on, it's his place. And the Jersey Devil never lets you forget it. I can see now that it was a mistake, but I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day. It was in a display case.
I guess he's hit hard times too. There's a lot of that going around. I can't imagine he has a lot of marketable skills.
So I guess, according to that combo option, Mary got the axe there.
Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man will come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble.
I'm not going to mention either of you, so calm your tits.
You know that butcher shop, the Cut Above? It's the place on Tubman Street. Same block as the baker and the candlestick maker. Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the Crooked Man. And I don't think it's meat in the packages.
Well, what are you delivering? What's going on there? How does this fit into the Crooked Man's operation?
I couldn't tell you, but I do know this. It's the only meat market in town that doesn't carry filet. I'm not sure how much actual butchery goes on there.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the Butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up, and it's still not enough.
It's Mary you deal with? Bloody Mary is there?
No, Johann is the one who hands over the packages, you know, day to day. But I've seen her around here. She gets under my skin, you know. I try to avoid her. But I don't need to tell you what she's
You're
like.
You're damn right you don't. I don't need a rundown on her reputation. If Mary works out of there, I need to look into it.
Oh, it's personal.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like this, scraping to get by.
None of us should. We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home. You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
I don't need to understand. It's not my fucking job to understand. My job is to keep Fable Town safe.
So, where are you going? If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
Where should I go? Where first?